Yeah, yeah. And with all the people involved and on board, it would be, it just adds to it, you know? As a businessman and a person that's done this my entire career, my entire life, you know, there's a lot to be said for production and profit margins. But I don't care how much profit I'm going to make off of something. If you're just disrespectful, I assume you take it somewhere else. Now, I got no time for people to disrespect me. Under the fence, they're going to get under the fence.
I was just waiting for who was going to say that animal is a burrowing animal. No fence is going to stop that.
But they put it as a zoning condition.
Oh, true.
And we had to build it. We had to build it. It was hilarious.
I love it.
I mean, it was just a fun story.
What was the last name? I said, let's see on the way of the
problem. Morgan?
Scott.
Scott Morgan.
What did you get?
It's right when you come out of the elevator.
You know.
You want one?
No.
Here.
We gave them 150-foot buffer. Because they were, you know, very nice homes and see. So on my lot.
Thank you, sir. Merry Christmas to you, too.
Merry Christmas.
That's okay.
Excuse me.
Me too.
ask you soon. It's a nice facility.
You let it go, didn't you?
Thank you, sir.
Exactly.
We've got a little pile full of those ones. By little, you do about 10 degrees of time. Takes the rest of the time off, pours it in.
We just got off on the back.
All right, we've got to skip that all back.
You see how many English ones you see some? Like I'm sorry, but I'm trying to work with that.
Sure. How are you?
Good. How are you?
response. I hear motion call me in order. Second. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. You would please stand and face quietly.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
So we have a copy of the agenda. Should I hear a motion to adopt the agenda? And the reason I'm requesting adoption of the agenda is because the public hearing held on December the 4th needs to be added to the minutes to the agenda, and I don't think that was done on their website, and that's an item that was inadvertently left off, so told that we need to adopt the agenda with that in mind, with the public hearing held on December the 4th. So the chair will entertain a motion to adopt the agenda with that addition.
Make a motion.
Motion and second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay. No need for executive session, I understand. Item three would be a consideration adoption of the minutes of the regular city council meeting of November the 20th, 2012, an executive session meeting of the same day, and a special call public hearing held on December the 4th. Council, would it be all right to adopt all these together? Or we need to individually adopt these?
Do it
either way. Do it all together?
Yes, sir.
Okay, the public hearing was budget hearing on December the 4th. It was a special call meeting. So I hear a motion to adopt the minutes.
Make a motion.
Got a motion to adjourn. Do you have a second?
Second.
Willis, any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Item four, nominations, proclamations, and resolutions. There being none. Under item five, old business, there being none. Item six, new business. I made the 2012 budget amendment, and this is a requirement of state law. Jeff, city clerk, you might address the budget amendment.
As you said, the state order requires municipalities and other entities to have a balanced budget. What this amendment does is requires to account for increases in revenue received or also in unexpected expenditures during the year. What we did is take the original budget, add in the additional income that we had received, and then appropriate that among the different departments where they're being budgeted by us.
Okay. What's the pleasure of the
board?
I have a motion. I have a second. Second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, item B, 2013 budget for adoption. As all of you got a copy of the proposed budget and at our last council meeting, and we later set up on December the 4th, there was a special call public hearing as required by law for the budget process. So the budget that's been being presented is for the general fund. We have $11,166,900 is proposed budget for the general fund for 2013. That's the proposed revenue that we've taken in, and that's proposed revenue that we divided up among the departments. So what's the pleasure of the board in the budget for the general fund for $11,166,900? Chair will entertain a motion.
Motion.
Got a motion from Rupert, have a second.
Second.
Second from Lewis, any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous, thank you very much. Okay, in the water and sewer budget, we have a proposed budget of $12,509,000. That's the budget that's been proposed, and that's the amount of revenue that's expected to be taken in, the amount of revenue to be spent. So, what's the pleasure of the board in reference to the water and sewer? Have a motion, have a second.
Second.
Got a motion and a second, any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Motion approved unanimously for $12,509,000 for water and sewer. Okay, in addition to that, we projected to take in $1 million for the SPOS. I have a motion to accept the proposed proposal for $1 million in the SPOS for the next year. Have a motion to have a second.
Second.
Got a second, any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Okay, with a total budget of the city coming for next year, which basically mimics last year except a slight increase, is $24,675,000 for next year. So that's the total budget for next year. Okay, in reference to budget, we have a resolution also that's required by the state. I hear a motion to adopt the resolution required by the state in reference to the budget.
Make a motion.
A second. A motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Planning and zoning. Conditional use permit for zoning application 2012-294. Does that call for a public hearing? Okay. I hear a motion to open up for a public hearing. Have a second. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Okay. Anyone would like to speak in favor of zoning application 2012-294? Please come up and state your name.
Thank you.
Excuse me, if I could, before we do that, can I make my staff?
Yeah, I'm sorry. Yeah.
That's all right. I just wanted to get that out of the way before we actually
zoning planning director.
Yes, sir. If I could please direct attention to staff reporting in your packet, I would like to present that report for the record. This is the Epiphany Orthodox Christian School of Mathematics and Science, Epiphany OCS for short, and they made application on behalf of the owner, which is West Maple LLC, West Maple Office Park, for conditional use permit to allow the private school to locate in the West Maple Office Park at 514 West Maple Street. The Epiphany OCS plans to operate from 8 a.m. to 2:30 p.m. and then provide elementary school laboratory to the students and the general public from 3 p.m. to 4 p.m. and then they'll provide aftercare for students until 6 p.m. A condition of the West Maple Office Park rezoning variance that you granted in 2008 was to plant the eastern boundary between the development and the Cumming Council authority with legal cypress or other vegetative plant approved by our department. Currently, there's a natural vegetative buffer on the eastern boundary, not planted one. However, there is a planted legal cypress buffer on the portion of the western boundary between the development and the single family homes on West Maple. It may be necessary to revisit that situation regarding that approval and variance in 2008, depending upon the proposed school location and future expansion of it. The planning board did hold a public hearing on this matter on November 20th, and there were no reported public comments. They did recommend approval to the council with the following seven conditions. Conditional one, letters of support must be received from all the current office park tenants regarding the proposed private school use. And if I could speak to that for a moment, in your packet behind the staff report, you'll find three letters of approval. One is from the healthcare products business, which actually will occupy, along with the school building 1200. They occupy two suites in building 1200, the proposed school is from the Law Center, which is located at Suite 101, and they issued more of a form letter, but they also said they had no problems with the school in the West Naval Office Park. And then the third letter is actually on Lance's jewelry letterhead. But Mr. Lance White is a member of the Forsyth County Humane Society. We're talking about Suite 104, and he also said that they would support the school location in the office park. So in fact, three of the five existing tenants provided letters of support in compliance with condition number one. Condition number two, the maximum number of students and staff will be 24 and 6, respectively, in the first year of the school operation. Condition number three, the parking plan for the school must include 15 to 22 spaces, including one handicap space. Future parking plans for the school must be approved by the planning and zoning board. Condition number four, Forsyth County Fire Marshal's Office will review and approve ADA life safety and occupancy plans as required. Condition number five, plans for the school playground must be approved by the planning and zoning department. Condition number six, school hours will be from 7 a.m. until 6 p.m., including the school laboratory and aftercare hours. And condition number seven, this conditional use permit will be referred by the city council at the June 2013 regular scheduled meeting. If I can speak to that for a moment, the reason for that last condition is that, as I understand it, and Ms. Lee, the principal of the school, may speak further about this, they will have a better idea at that point in time what their demands will be as far as school, students, and staff for the following year. And that's why we ask them to come back in June before you all to see if perhaps condition number two of the maximum number of school and staff might be revised. I think that's dependent on their enrollment at that point in time for the following school year. That's the staff report. We have set the condition to go about planning whether or not we have to answer any questions that you might have on that.
One of the things that I don't see in this whether it's in a traffic survey, that's this project here off of West Maple has very limited access from the standpoint of Maple Street. And that doesn't come up to the state required width of roads from the standpoint of heavy traffic, heavy bus, even regular traffic, so to speak. It doesn't have shoulders on the road in this kind of thing. That's one of the things. I'm just concerned about the safety of the kids and so forth versus one of the schools. So, and I didn't see a traffic study being made.
The planning board looked at that, but they opted not to propose that condition. But if the council desires to, they can propose whatever additional conditions or complete any condition that you want.
Now, I think the last time that I visited, I don't know if any of the board members have visited that. I believe the streets inside that development is substandard. I don't think they've ever done the final paving and that kind of thing in it.
They have, of course, our ordinance requires that until the development is 95% complete, the final topping is not required. But we perhaps could have them, if they haven't already, we could have them do the final topping to the area. And I think perhaps it has been done. The existing building was 100, 212, but it hasn't where the building stopped and the rest of the park building roads laid out around the top of the top and down in those areas.
Okay. Thank you. Any council have any questions? Thank you, Scott. You're welcome. Okay. I assume everything was withdrawn from the open for public hearing, so we'll go through that process again. I hear most of the open for public hearing. We'll have sent to all in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Anybody would like to speak in favor of the project, ma'am? Come to me.
Thank you, Mr. Gravitt.
You would state your name for the record, please.
My name is Sydney Lee, and
ninth.
Scott Gamble.
Obviously, y'all are involved with the school, and y'all are obviously in favor of it.
But it's the same way, yes, sir. Our objective is that we are very anxious to all of the community surrounding the aides, not just here in town, but also to explore education and community as a whole.
How many students you plan on initially having?
We have a maximum of 24 students for one pre-K two-year-old classroom and one pre-K three-year-old classroom.
How many students you eventually propose to have?
The building will have a total capacity of 70, and that's including the adults.
So to clarify a little bit, right, and that's based on the fire marshal pass. So our intention was to open the Quincy Orthodox Christian School with a focus on mathematics and science. Our intention was to open doors March or April timeframe as soon as we get the help completed. And then we could get the construction done, open doors, and start enrolling our preschool students. This also allows our, when we deploy or open our K through five, which is intended to open in fall 2013, if we have doors open in March or late April, this will allow our clients to come in and then check out where the school will physically be located. And of course, we'll go ahead and have the preschool open, start generating some revenues.
Are you, are you saying where your school will permanently be located? Are you talking about temporary for this location?
Well, so where our intention is, we signed a 3-year lease, and we started off with one building that's roughly 4,500 square feet. That's just get the preschool doors open. Now, once we have our enrollment, we'll be continue to enroll pretty much through the first quarter and second quarter. At that point, we'll look at, okay, now we need to add additional space. So our intention is to be there a minimum of 3 years. And in working with the developer of the property, there's a total of 5.5 acres. So potentially, you know, God willing, we'll have, you know, 500 students enrolled, and then the owner said, hey, we'll build a big two-story building structure. So our intention is just to open doors March, April for preschool, knowing that we will add or rent additional space for the K through five in the fall 2013. Did that answer your question?
You have, I don't think that location would ever got be able to have 500, you know.
Well, we would love to have that problem.
But anyway, thanks.
Okay.
Any other questions? Council? No. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Anyone else?
Yes, sir. How about the general prior commitment wants to be able to be here tonight, but he asked me to read a letter that he'd written to you. Do we have Gravitt City Council? Unfortunately, I cannot be present in the meeting this evening due to previous commitment. Therefore, I ask Scott Hamlin to present this item on my behalf. As the developer and the property owner of West Maple Office Park, I believe that this leading is the Orthodox Christian School bring growth and exposure to this department, both of which are positive for the parking and as we discussed in great detail, the changes that will come. In no way will this negatively impact the current tenants. My goal is to have a long-term relationship with my tenants and maintain the desirable place of business. The majority of the existing businesses within West Maple Office Park are supported in the city and the school. Due to the struggling economy, many office parks have become pretty stressed and remain vacant. We've been very fortunate to remain in business and maintain the active office park in excellent condition while actively seeking tenants. I hope you'll see the school at a positive impact on the city of time and support and approve the request to move forward with this project. Thank you for your time. And the there was one other approval letter from a chiropractor that's located in the park. And I'm not sure what happened, but she was okay with the school.
The letters of see in the packet here, I think we have maybe three of them. The one of them in particular that I was looking at was with Tiger Law Center. And he says the law firm in principle is not in principle opposed to the school.
Correct. He has recently signed a lease. Prior to him signing the lease, it was fully disclosed to him that the school was going to be there. Because we're going to allow the school to use that suite as a temporary office. And prior to him signing the lease, we had to get the school to acknowledge that they were going to move the suite. So he's fully aware of the school.
Okay. Any council have anything? Thank you very much. Okay.
Good evening, gentlemen. My name is Jason May. I also am here to represent on behalf of the Lithium School. I wanted to kind of touch base on some of the questions that Chairman Gravitt had here for us in regards to traffic. They were concerns that we're trying to deal with up front. Like we explained earlier, this is a phased project. We're trying to open just a couple of classrooms right now with the ball rolling as things move forward and the student body grows from year to year. We've got options on all of the remaining building pads through the development, as well as an out parcel we contain 21,000 square foot freestanding building. Has access into this, create a secondary access going into this as well. So the idea is, as we move forward, we stay on top of our growth rates so that we can inform the developers, we have enough time to build, and at the same time, we're coming back in June to inform the council, hey, we're really growing, and so we're going to be adding more buildings. And at that point, the idea behind that is, how do you deal with traffic? How do you deal with those safety issues that come into play? We need to add topping, the rest of the development that's undeveloped at this point, which the infrastructure is in those types of scenarios. We should be easily transitioned in. But like I said, as an this type of development, it makes it very simple for us to stay on top of this growth, manage it, stay in touch with Scott and everybody else that's around here in council as we move forward. Every year is required for this hub. This coming up here. Scott had talked about a little bit about what we were doing. We had some questions about parking that we had dealt with previously. We're going to be adding additional parking to the site. I mean, we've got a site plan on it as well. We'll have to deal with more than that. And we're going to develop a traffic flow pattern that will meet the fire department safety criteria, leaving the lane accessible all the way through the facility for a fire vehicle, emergency vehicles, for injuries at any time to access. By using that flow pattern, by traveling all the way to the rear of the undeveloped portion, moving back in, keep it out, creating a natural stacking lane inside of an undeveloped section of the facility, on top of over 30 parking spaces that we'll be adding, more than excessive for what we need in this type of development scenario. So the idea is, let's keep it overly safe, let's make it look right, let's break it down into pieces. And as our growth moves forward, we get to expand in this development, building additional buildings, and acquiring more property with a long-term potential goal of maybe taking out the back and the 21,000 square foot facility in the front. All of which would have to be all city, state, county guidelines and developed by the
way. Okay.
Do you have any questions?
Council, have any questions? Jason? Thank you, Jason. Anyone else like to say in favor of the project?
Good evening, Mr. Ball, the architect of the Pilgrim Council. So, I just want to let you know that we have done a preliminary study on the building already. It is a strength building. We will be providing additional fire exits for the children to be able to be there now. We'll be addressing any concerns as far as building codes and building requirements go for its assembly type uses. So if there's any questions on that, I'm here tonight as well as answer those questions.
Council, have any questions?
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else like to speak in favor of the school? Anyone here like to speak in opposition? Your motion to public hearing be proposed.
Make a motion.
A motion and a second, any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous, thank you very much. Okay, for Scott, as I alluded to earlier, I don't think anybody has any opposition for the school. I think the only thing is safety for the children. Is the Maple Street. I'm very familiar with that because I lived that there all my life, basically a few years ago. And the Maple Street is a very narrow road, and the safety standpoint is the only thing that concerns me about the 20, 30 kids today, maybe they grow in as time goes on, maybe the 2030 won't be that big a deal. But do you think that we should do a traffic study on it and see what it would do?
Here's one thing we've been doing there is, as Jason alluded to, as a condition of the plan, where they'll be coming back before you again in June of next year. I think at that point they can probably offer additional information as far as total enrollment, staff, and where that's heading for the school year that fall. I think at that point it could be logical to say, you know, if it's grown beyond this 24 students, beyond the critical enrollment, we set back and as part of that review of that company June 13 and say, well, maybe we need to look at having traffic setting up and what possible improvements on flow and ingress and egress from Maple Street itself. I think you know that of course is up to your discretion, but I think for the time being, for what they need, it's just
what do you think about the park itself from the standpoint of I know you said you need to wait till it's 90% complete before you require the full pavement and so forth and the top coat, so to speak. What's your feelings for that?
It could be now, since what they're talking about doing in terms of traffic flow, a pattern that Jason spoke about. In fact, you know, maybe using emergency equipment to utilize that. An additional condition right now would be to have the developer and the owner agree to put the topping on the remainder, or at least that portion of the unoccupied part of the park, put the topping on that portion of it, so that the vehicles, service vehicles, and even the parents that drop the students off and so forth aren't going from a finished area to an unfinished area back onto a finished area. So it might make sense to have them put the topping on now as a condition for that portion of the park that's going to utilize this.
Maybe the engineering firm could go out and look at it and see if that's already out. So go ahead and do that part.
Sure. Yeah. That's okay. Yeah, well, I'll go there and do that for us.
Okay. Council, have any other questions? Thank you, Scott. Mm-hmm. I will be back up for Gerald, make a motion.
Make a motion.
All in favor, have a second. I say, all in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous, thank you very much. I think, obviously, we all want to see much education as we can in the community, that we can get in the community, and certainly if anybody's opposed to this, we'll be opposed to it, but I certainly our issue is the safety of kids and so forth with this. I would say with anybody is a motion to approve it, that it be accompanied with asking our engineering firm from Morton Acabella to do an inspection on it and see what the preference would be as far as streets hadn't been dedicated and they're not city streets, but at some point in time, that would probably come before the city when it's complete. Okay. Chair, I entertain a motion then CUP zoning request of 201-2294, what's the pleasure of the board? I have a motion from John D. Is that to approve the project proposal? Do I have a second?
Mr. Mayor, before you vote, I just want to make sure for the record, are you adding conditions 8 and 9? Condition 8, as I heard you just say, I just want to make sure what the motion is. We include the products stated by the one out there before occupancy. Condition 9 would be hopping the wall being parked drive areas so that the staffing issue that Mr. Mayor is talking about, I just want to make sure what y'all are voting.
That's what I would recommend, that we get from safety issue and from future roads condition. Obviously, we don't want a situation to come up where the city will have to maintain it before we ever take it over and then be substandard to start with. So,
your motion includes the seven conditions.
I'm saying it that way, but I think that I'd recommend that be in the motion. If that the motion for that to be accepted. Okay.
Excuse me, you're right. You're right. Thank you.
I have a second for Rupert.
Yes.
Any discussion? All in favor for approval with the condition? Raise your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, under item B, police department under the item one would be here in my package sales. License application, Scott Morgan.
Casey,
I'm sorry.
Hey, everyone. Do I need to do one at a time or are you going to do a group
A little bit of individual.
Okay. The first application was received from Country Corn City that was located at 602 Conger Highway. It's for license for sale of beer and wine by the package. The licensee is Luton and Wani. Background investigation was conducted, nothing was discovered, there were completely issues with alcohol license. All appropriate fees have been paid, and licensee are in compliance with the city and alcohol orders. And I would recommend the license name.
Okay. Is this the store that burned that, Lincoln Highway?
Is this actually across the street from
us? Oh, across the street. Okay. The old one has been renovated.
Correct.
Okay. We've got a recommendation of Allium Enterprise LLC of Country Corner Chipco. Recommendation by the chief for approval. What's the pleasure of the board? Motion approved. Have a second. 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 Is any discussion?
That guy has really done a lot to clean up the inside of that, a lot of renovation inside. It's a pretty nice store now. I've been in there.
Glad to see you cleaned up. That's a well meeting. Okay. So you didn't put it on. Motion and second. Any other discussion? All in favor, signify, raise your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay. Item B, of Enterprise LLC, Chevron Food Mall.
This is located at 554 Atlanta Road, which is across from Honea, so right by the Parkway Plaza. This is the store that just has, been remodeled and reopened as well. The licensee in this is Juan Wilson Haley. Application was received from him for a license for the sale of the wine by the package. And then the investigation was conducted. All fees were paid. There's nothing completely with license. He granted the license. I would recommend she grant the license.
Okay. Chief's recommendation of the Enterprise Chevron Food Mart, sale of packaged wine and beer. What's the pleasure of the board? Motion approved. Have a second. Second. Yes, any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Okay. Item C, Uncar Incorporated, In and Out Grocery.
Yes, sir. This is a renewal for the second big camp highway.
Okay.
In the scene is a licensee. They applied for a license for several years, mine by the package. And then background investigation, nothing has changed on the business. It's the same licensee as what they've been in the past. And nothing to disclose with the issues of it and how it works.
Recommendation by the chief for in-house grocery. Beer and wine package, but sales license. Be approved by special board. Motion to have a second. Second, all in favor, city fund raise your hand. Unanimous. Thank you, chief. Okay, item eight, Department of Utilities. John Kirk.
Mayor and members of the city council, last month we came and requested that you allow us to look at the state contract bid for a F-550 dump truck chassis. Did that. We also checked with local Ford dealerships to see if there were any 550s on the lot. We went to Billy Howell Ford and talked to him about the state contract bid and see if he could match it. He could not find, they used the computer system to scan the southeast to see if they could find a chassis who was going to be found. There were some trucks that had bodies on them, you know, like service bodies. So, make a long story short, we're requesting that you allow the Department of Utilities to purchase the 2013 Ford F-550 dump truck and the bid on the state contract from way forward is $37,183. This was budgeted by 2012. We'll have to order the truck at sometime in March.
Okay, I have written on mine, you got $37,483 in summary, and I have $34,800. Is that 34,800 pound truck? Because, wait, well, I think you wrote that on there, John, on mine. Okay. All right, the price of it, though, was $37,483.
Yes, that's correct.
Okay. And I might add, when we was talking about the budget amendment, we didn't, even though that's been in the budget all year, the reason we hadn't put bids on this because we didn't know we'd have enough money to do it. So we had the money to come in, so this is where this should be put to buy the this extra. So anyway, we got request, recommendation, John Hurd for our distribution department, water truck. For the water department for $37,483, that'd be a Ford F-550 dump truck. So, chair will entertain a motion.
Make a motion to accept the bid.
Got a motion to have a second.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much, John. Item B is a mini excavator with a trailer.
For many excavator and trailer, we advertised in the South County newspaper and requested bids. We had sealed bids. We were fortunate to have 8 bids on the mini excavator. And the lowest bid was from Bobcat of Atlanta at $44,023. And the Department of Utilities is recommending that we accept the lowest bid for the Bobcat mini excavator at that $44,023. And this is for the Mr. Green
Excavator. I'm looking at the bid. It looked like you had, what, 7 bids?
What do you guys think?
7 or 8 bids here. The low bid we recommended by Kettle amount for $44,023.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What's the pleasure of the board?
Make a motion.
Motion approved. Have a second. Second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Okay. Item C is replacement trailer bid. John?
Mr. Mayor, if you back up to the previous line item, we still have to vote on the trailer. And the trailer came from a different company called Order Equipment. And this is a 20-foot trailer that will be used call the new penny excavator, and it's the next page in the package. This is a 20-foot trailer, and the low bid came from Border Equipment at $3,805, and we have compared all the trailers, they're similar in construction, and we believe that the low bid is the one good bid.
Okay, I noticed Bobcat of Atlanta was $4,550, and Border Equipment was $3,805, and that's the same trailer?
Same trailer, it's $700 cheaper.
Okay. So you had, it looks like about 7 bids on that, and that was low bid, so. This is a trailer to haul the excavator, so what's the pleasure of the board? The board equipped with $3,805.
Make a motion, will you say?
Have a motion, do I have a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. You down, thank you very much. Okay, item two, A, Fossil's, money for bids, John Hurd.
Mayor, I hate to back up on that, we've got a second trailer, another trailer.
Oh, it's another trailer?
Yes, sir. I'm so sorry, it's line out of speed.
Yeah, okay.
This is a 25-foot trailer, and it's to replace an older aging trailer with some safety issues, and we also have 7 bids for it, and it looks good, came from Border Equipment in at $7,139.
Okay, I'm going to come ahead of $7,139, right?
Yes.
Yes. That's also Border Equipment.
Yes, yes.
And you're comparing the same trailers with those also. Okay, what's the pleasure of the board?
Make a motion.
Motion to Ralph, have a second. Second, Quincy, any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. You down, thank you very much. Okay, now we get to item two, wastewater, phosphorus, honey, bids.
We also advertise for bids for this piece of equipment. Another item that we pledged to was 2012 budget. We got 2 bids. It's a specialized piece of equipment, not any company that actually sell it. Fortunately, one of the 2 bids, and the low bid was an applied spectrometry EDH for $12,000.
Okay. Hayward Charlotte was $13,550, but the other bid, right?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, and this was budgeted as this year, yeah. Okay. All right. We have a request for phosphorus monitoring equipment. The bids were applied spectrometer PhD for $12,000, recommended by John Hurd, Director of Utilities, what's the pleasure of the board?
Make a motion, lowest bid.
Motion to Ralph, second, Quincy, any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. You down, thank you very much, John.
Mayor, members of the council.
Item F, real estate acquisition, contract for 72 acres. Property on the near 400 Parkway and Pilgrim Road, PLM Associates LLC, name.
Mr. Mayor, members of the council, at the November 20th executive session, the council authorized the extension of an offer to the owner of the 72 acres located on the near 400 Parkway, which was a PLM Associates. Briefly describe that property for you. It is a 72-acre tract that is bordered on one side by Lakeside 400 Parkway, where it currently dead ends next to the county juvenile court and sheriff's offices. The tract runs parallel to Georgia 400, generally in the northerly direction, and then it turns and comes towards Pilgrim Road, which is the city's existing property. That it owns that fronts Dover Mill Road right near the creek. The offer that the city authorized for this property was $25,500 per acre for the property that was not encumbered by the Forsyth County waterline easement, and $12,500 per acre for the land that was encumbered by the water easement. That offer has been accepted by PLM Associates. It would be appropriate at this time if approve this contract and to authorize the mayor to close it. One of the terms of acceptance by PLM Associates was that the closing would occur before year end, so it occurred before December 31st of this year. Again, it's about 72 acres. Of that 72 acres, a little over 4 acres is comprised in the water line easement, and that water line easement runs directly parallel to the Georgia 400 right-of-way from south to north, and that's why the county has a water line. Because of the easement, we offered less for that property. Again, that was 12.5 acres for that, those approximately 4-plus acres, and there being 68 and 72, we had 25.5. But to answer any questions.
Council, have any questions? Again, this was requested of the board executive meeting of November the 20th. So what's the pleasure of the board? The question is to authorize the mayor to sign the necessary documents to acquire the property.
I like the motion.
Question, motion from Brown.
Is that the same property that the county had under contract to put the road at $150,000?
I believe it is, Councilman Sexton. I believe it is. It is certainly part of it. I think they're looking at even more, but that is a part of it. And it does adjoin just the existing property that the city owns and has already designated for our municipal. Yes, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I have a motion. Draft, second, Rupert. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, very much.
Okay, item 7, under announcements, City Hall will be closed December 24th and 25th and New Year's Day of January the 1st. Also performing at the Playhouse, Branson on the Road, performing at the Cumming Playhouse December 28th to the 31st with two performances. New Year's Day. That concludes the live schedule week of this year. I'd like to thank the City Council and all the staff who've worked so hard and diligently to make the city what it is and what it had planned for as far as the budget's concerned. Gerald and Steve and staff worked on the budget along with the department heads and did a great job in doing so.